Hi, and welcome back to Dwayne's Guitar Lessons. Today I'd like to work on showing you a new chord. This is the B minor chord. This one's very difficult to play, but it's real popular in a lot of songs. And there's two ways you can do it. You can either do it in bar chord formation, like this, which is kind of difficult. You've got to take your first finger and bar it over all the strings, in this particular instance, five strings. Because your B is right here, so you'd want to bar against these five strings. Put your second finger on the second string, third fret. Your third finger on the fourth string, fourth fret. And your pinky on the third string underneath it on the fourth fret. Okay, that's your B minor chord. Or if you have a hard time barring, you can also take your first finger and put it on the first string like this. This is a little bit easier for a lot of people. A lot of people have a hard time with bar chords. I know I had a hard time with it when I was learning it a long time ago. But if you practice them, they're very much like your power chords, except you're using all your fingers. When you play your power chords that we've talked about before, you're just using two fingers. Well, in this case, you're using your other two fingers as well. So like for instance, when we play Iron Man here at the fifth fret, we're just using these two fingers. Well, if we put these two fingers down, our second and fourth finger down, now we're playing an actual whole bar chord. So a bar chord is kind of an extended power chord is how I would explain it, okay? That's basically what it is. You're just using all your fingers now. And you're kind of barring now with this as well, which makes it a lot more difficult. So you can do it like that, or like I said, you could do it like this. Put your first finger on the first string, second fret. Now what I like to do is play a song for you that incorporates the B minor, and this is a really popular one. This is a real challenging song as well. It just uses the basic chords that we've talked about. G, C, D, our infamous B minor, E minor, and of course, and A minor as well. So it's what, like six chords. The last video I did was Margaritaville, with only had three chords. This one's got six. I'd like to do this one just because it incorporates that B minor. And it's kind of challenging because he plays the chords a lot. And we're still going to use that same strumming that we did before. Okay, and I'll play a little bit for you so you understand what I'm talking about. So it's going to go like this. Still using the same kind of techniques that I've talked about before. That same strumming, that down, down, up, up, down. Okay, and we're using the G, the D, the C, and what makes it difficult is just he's changing the chords all the time. Those same chords, but he's just changing them a lot. So that's what makes it kind of challenging, okay? So I'm going to play it for you now. This is Against the Wind by Bob Seger, and you can kind of play along with it if you like. And once again, I've got my iPod plugged into a couple external speakers. And this is coming off his live album, Nine Tonight. And this is Against the Wind by Bob Seger. So here we go. Let's see how it sounds. Thank you. there. So there you go. Again, swing by Bob Seger using that infamous B minor chord. So I'd recommend working on that. A couple ideas you could try for learning to bar is put your finger across the strings and maybe put your second finger over the top of it, press the strings together with your thumb in the back, and kind of move up and down the fretboard like this. That's kind of what I did a long time ago when I was learning to play bar chords. And or just try to form the chord itself and just kind of try to hold it there. Your hand's going to cramp up a little bit, but you know, once again, take a break, shake it off, and then come back to it. And you'll see after a while you'll get it. But if you don't want to do the bar chords, like I said, you can also play the B minor like this with your first finger. But I would recommend trying to incorporate bar chords into your chord vocabulary, because they really help out in a lot of songs. And that B minor is a good one to start with, okay? So thank you very much for watching. Appreciate it. And I hope you got something out of that. And I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks.